Right. First of all, the word amma. You see, amma is harfu shartin wa tafseel. What's amma called? Harfu shartin wa tafseel. What does this mean? Okay, number one. And it's always when it's used, it has a fa after it. So imma is different. It's amma. Okay? Imma will come up later on. We have amma here. So what does amma mean? And you call the amma, you call the fa that comes here, rabitatun lil jawab. So in Turkey, basically, muqaddama is mubtada and fil mabadi until the end is a khabar. But then you put in the amma and the fi, the fa. That's how the amma is used. When you choose amma, you write amma when you've mentioned two or more, you mention something vaguely, or you've mentioned two or more things vaguely, or just simply, without any explanation. Thereafter, you mention each one with detail. This is Zayd, this is Amr, this is Bakr. هذا زيد وهذا عمر وهذا بكر. أما زيد فطالب أما بكر فمهندس أما خالد فتاجر. So for example, look in the Quran, easy example. Allah says, كذبت ثمود وعاد بالقارعة. ثمود and عاد both rejected the قارعة. قرأ يقرأ قرعا knock. And here it means a knocking and a very, like, you've got a very harsh knock on the door. So قرعة is one of the names of قيامة. So كذبت ثمود وعاد بالقارعة. عاد and ثمود both rejected the last hour. Mentioned two people, two nations vaguely. Then he goes on to say, mention each one in detail. أما ثمود, sorry, ف. وأما عاد ف. So when you mention two or more things ambiguously or vaguely without any detail first, then you wish to proceed to explain in more detail. What do you add? أما, which is called حرف شرط وتفصيل, on the مبتدا, followed by فا on the خبر. For example, so هذا. هذا هداية النحو وذلك كافية. Correct. أما هداية النحو. أما هداية النحو فللمبتدئين. فللمبتدئين. As for هداية النحو, it is for the beginners. أما كافية فللمتوسطين. For the medium students. Fahim? You got it? Now. So that's what we're saying here. So you don't have to translate fa, but that is how fa is structured, how fa is used with amma.